ضربت عليهم الذلة. Now this is the same ayah which we have read in Surah Al-Baqarah. ضربت عليهم الذلة والمسكنة وباءوا بغضب من الله ذلك بأنهم كانوا يكفرون بآيات الله ويقتلون النبيين بغير الحق ذلك بما عصوا وكانوا يعتدون. It appeared there in the end of the seventh section with a little difference. This ayah and the essence and the subject of matter of this ayah has been repeated here. ضربت عليهم الذلة. On them humiliation has been struck, humiliation has been heaped. أَيْنَمَا سُقِفُوا, wherever they will be found. إِلَّا بِحَبْلٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَحَبْلٍ مِنَ النَّاسِ. Now here we have an exception. Except when they are in the bondage of some covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, maybe they revert to the covenant, then you know they will become an exception. Or they are in the bondage of a covenant or treaty with other people. This is the condition today. They are living under the protection of the Christians. They themselves are nothing. They can't survive. But you know, except for the help that they are getting from the whole of the Christian world. Now the matter of the fact is, that they are actually overriding the Christian world. But this is a very temporary phenomenon. Very soon the tables are going to be turned. But at presently, they are controlling the policies of the Christian world. So to say, they have conquered the Christian world. First of all, they used the West, the white Anglo-Saxon Protestant. They were their tools. They were using them. But now they have conquered even the Catholic world. Because, as you know, the Pope had absolved them from the charge of crucifying Jesus. By a decree, the Pope has said that they are not responsible. The Jews of today, they are not to blame. Number two, you know, now the Vatican has recognized Israel, and there is going to be a diplomatic mission from Vatican to Jerusalem for Israel. So these events are casting their shadows, you know, and the things that have been prophesied by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they are now coming very soon. Anyhow, the present condition is that they are under the patronage and protection of the Christian world. إِلَّا بِحَبْلِ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَحَبْلِ مِنَ النَّاسِ وَبَعُوا بِغَضَبٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ, and they incurred the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَضُرِبَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمِسْكُ مَسْكَنًا, and weakness has been and humiliation has been heaped upon them. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يَكْفُرُونَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ. This is because they have been denying and belying the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَقْتُلُونَ الْأَنْبِيَاءَ بِغَيْرِ حَقٍّ, and they have been killing and murdering even the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without any reason, without any fault of theirs. ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ, and to this end they have reached. Why? Because they had been breaking and transgressing the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they had been crossing the limits of Sharia. لَيْسُوا سَوَاءَ, again the same ayah. All of them are not equal. لَيْسُوا سَوَاءَ, all of them are not equal, not similar. من أهل الكتاب أمة قائمة يتلون آيات الليل آيات الله آناء الليل وهم يسجدون. Among these people of the book, there are some individuals who are upright and who recite during the nights the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they pass their nights in prostrations. So there were individuals, a few individuals, but they were there. Just as in the Muslim Ummah, there are individuals who are very pious. خال خال اس قوم میں اب تک نظر آتے ہیں, وہ کرتے ہیں اشکِ سحرگاہی سے جو ظالم وضو. There are very pious individuals. But you know, the حکم الاکثر حکم الکل. What is the condition of the maximum number, maximum majority of the ummah? So the whole ummah will be regarded on the basis of that majority. That is the position here, and that was the position 1400 years ago of the Jews. لَيْسُوا سَوَاءَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ أُمَّةٌ قَائِمَةٌ يَتْلُونَ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ آنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ وَهُمْ يَسْجُدُونَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ, and they believe in Allah and also the last day. وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, and they enjoin whatever is good. وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنكَرِ, and they forbid whatever is bad. وَيُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ, and they compete with each other and vie with each other in piety and in acts of virtue. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. And definitely they are from among the pious people. وَمَا يَفْعَلُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَلَنْ يُكْفَرُوهُ. And whatever good they will commit, whatever good deeds they will earn, they will not be deprived of their reward. وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah very well knows these people who are really God-fearing, who are really pious. وَمَا يَفْعَلُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَلَنْ يُكْفَرُوهُ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالْمُتَّقِينَ. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَنْ تُغْنِي عَنْهُمْ أَمْوَالُهُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا. On the contrary, those who have adopted kufr, who have committed kufr, who have chosen to remain kafir, their wealth and properties and their progeny, their children, will not be able to save them from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. And they are the people of fire, and they will remain and dwell in that fire forever. مَثَلُ يَمَّا يُنْفِقُونَ فِي هَذِهِ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. The likeliness of that which they are spending in this world, in this life of this world, كَمَثَلِ رِيْهِنْ فِيهَا سِرٌ. It is like a very whirlwind in which there is intense cold. أَصَابَتْ حَرْثَ قَوْمٍ. And that wind fell on the farm, on the tillage of a nation, ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ, who had wronged themselves, فَأَهْلَكَتْهُ, and they destroyed the whole of the tillage, the whole of the crop. وَمَا ظَلَمَهُمُ اللَّهُ وَلَكِنْ أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not wronged these people, but they have been doing wrong to themselves. Now this infaq, which is mentioned here about those people who were not believing in Allah and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this can be of two types. Every person does some act of charity, howsoever bad he might be, but he, for the contentment of his own conscience, he does something. But these things are not acceptable in the eyes of Allah unless a person has real iman and he is sincere in committing and in doing that act of charity. So this is like, you know, one man might be hoping that I have some good deeds with me, but on the day of judgment he finds he has nothing, just as a storm comes and a crop is burnt away. Number two, they were spending their money, lots of their money, for obstructing the way of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is a reference actually to their spending of money, because the mu'mineen, they were spending for the cause of Allah, and these kuffar, they were spending for the cause of kufr, for their own ideals. So actually this simile is meant for them. These are two possibilities. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَتَّخِذُوا بِطَانَةً مِّن دُونِكُمْ. O you who believe, don't take intimate friends for yourself except from your own self. You should have them from among the Muslims. لَا يَعْلُونَكُمْ خَبَالًا. They don't spare any pains for you. They are always striving to give you pains and injuries. They are always against you. وَدُّوا مَا عَنِتُّمْ. Whatever hurts you, they like it. قَدْ بَدَتِ الْبَغْضَاءُ مِنْ أَفْوَاهِهِمْ. Their enmity has become evident from their own mouths. Whatever they have been speaking, whatever they have been saying, from that it is evident that there is enmity in their hearts. وَمَا تُخْفِي صُدُورَهُمْ أَكْبَرُ. And the amount of enmity that their hearts are hiding, that is much more great. Only, you know, a tip of the iceberg. Whatever is apparent and evident from what they say, it is the tip of the iceberg. The real iceberg is in their hearts. They have the big and great enmity for you, O Muslim. تَبَيَّنَّا لَكُمُ الْآيَاتِ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. We have made our ayat, our guidance clear for you, for إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ, if only you can understand. هَانْتُمُ لَا تُحِبُّونَهُ. You are those who love them. وَلَا يُحِبُّونَكُمْ. But they don't love you. Muslims were of good nature. They thought, you know, about these are human beings. We must be good to all humans. هَوْ أَنْتُمْ هَوْ لَا تُحِبُّونَهُمْ. You love them. وَلَا يُحِبُّونَكُمْ. They don't love you. وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْكِتَابِ كُلِّهِ. And you have faith in all the book. All the book? Torah, Injil, and Quran. You believe in all the books. وَإِذَا لَقُوكُمْ قَالُوا آمَنَّا. When they meet you, they say, we also believe. وَإِذَا خَلَوْا. And when they are in privacy, أَغْضُوا عَلَيْكُمُ الْأَنَامَنَا أَنَامِلَا مِنَ الْغَيْسِ. They bite at their tips of the fingers from rage over you. قُلْ مُوتُوا بِغَيْظِكُمْ. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you perish with your own rage. You burn with your own fire of rage and enmity. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala very well knows what is there in the hearts of the people, what is there in the chests of the people. إِن تَمْسَفْتُمْ حَسَنَةٌ تَسُوْهُمْ. If some good thing comes to you, something with which you are happy, it is bad for them. It vexes them. وَإِن تُصِبْكُمْ سَيِّئَةٌ. If there is some trouble for you, some painful thing happens for you, يَفْرَهُ بِهَا. They are very happy, they rejoice. وَإِن تَصْبِرُوا وَتَتَّقُوا. But even then, if you show patience and you, if you have taqwa, two things. وَسْتَعِنُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ. The same thing here. إِن تَصْبِرُوا, if you have perseverance and patience, and if you have real taqwa, لَا يَضُرُّكُمْ كَيْدُهُمْ شَيْئًا. Their conspiracies, their plannings, their plotting, everything will go in vain. They will not be able to do you any permanent harm. إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ مُحِيطٌ. Allah Ta'ala is encircling, has encircled whatever they are doing. They cannot go beyond that circle. They cannot go beyond the will of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ وَنَفَعَنِي وَإِيَّاكُمْ بِالْآيَاتِ وَالذِّكْرِ الْحَكِيمِ.